Kron?
No.
Is that a government car?
Church.
Is that where you work?
I volunteer.
These are fine young men, Philip. They look up to you. Once things have stabilized here, they will be a powerful force for good.
And until then?
Keep moving forward.
Thank you. I know.
Hey, watch your step.
Watch your step.
Okay, good.
Manti, where is Abubakar?
He'll come.
Should we wait for him? Should we?
No, it will just worry everyone.
Thank you.
Are you ready?
Yes, I am.
Katika Ronke Delia, having been commissioner.
You almost missed it.
I got stuck in the mud. Poor thing. You're starting to get old. And on top of that, there were rebels. Children of gangs. Stealing car parts.
They stopped you?
No need. I was a mouse in a trap. I couldn't leave the car. And that got them curious.
But they didn't do anything to you.
They asked if I was crying. They wanted to intimidate me.
You don't need to fear us.
And if I'm Kran?
Oh, you are not.
But if I am, what then? Shall I fear the rebels?
We want only to be treated fairly.
That is what we all want.
Congratulations, Akatika.
Thank you.
We'll be by Sunday morning to work with you to church.
You wait here. I'll be back for you.
Don't worry. We'll be fine. It's still light enough.
Don't worry, Brother Abubakar.
Brother Abubakar can't help it. He was born to worry.
Yeah, it's true, you know. My mother never worried because I did enough for the both of us. You hurry back, okay?
We will.
Let's move.
Don't worry too much. I'm sure that we can.
Wardrobe.
Church isn't going to wait for us.
Uh-huh.
Your turn.
Amen. Are you okay?
What? Yeah, sure.
Good. Grab your tag.
Excuse me, Sister Kartika, the missionary is Minty Mays. They did not come visit church today.
No, I waited for them. They didn't show up. I came by myself.
I see. I'm sorry they were not there.
It's no problem. I would come either way.
I believe you.
Is everything all right?
Excuse me. Elders, we have to go now. Now.
All right,
Wait, I'm coming with you.
Thank you.
Where are you going? You want to get back? What are you talking about? We cannot stay here anymore.
Rebel activity last night, and all this Minty and mice have not been seen.
Really?
Abubakar, easy.
Come on, watch out, there's a car.
Sorry about that.
We need to get there, Abubakar.
You're going to hit somebody if you continue like this.
Abubakar, easy, man. Come on.
What if something happened to them? What will I say to President Kanigam?
I should have been there for them this morning. The savior promises to gather his people as a hen gathers her chick under her wings. That's why we go to church every week.
Maybe next time.
Okay, I'll take that as a yes.
How do you do that?
What?
Talk to people so easily.
Do I?
Yeah. You can just go up to someone you don't know like it's nothing.
Yeah, it's nothing. Just say hello.
No, it's not that easy.
Have you tried?
I'm not good at talking to people.
Then why are you here?
To teach people, I guess.
How can you teach people if you can't talk to them?
I teach by example.
Example of not opening your mouth.
Hey, missionaries.
You should come to church with us, David. Your God will love it.
But goats don't belong at church.
Did you know that?
What?
That goats don't belong at church. Isn't that just nonsense?
Hey,
I've seen all types at church.
Yeah, being funny.
You're too smart for us. But bring you and your family along this week.
Okay, I'll tell them.
Learn about a good shepherd. Sounds good?
Yes.
That's my guy. Take care of yourself. Don't forget to bring your goods. You see? Easy.
You say so.
Is that rebels?
What are you doing out here? You shouldn't be here.
We're just teaching about...
I know who you are. Are you trying to get shot?
They're not after missionaries.
No. They are after Christ.
Gaye?
Yes.
My name. It shows that I'm a Kran.
Shoot on the Kran.
Apartments, are they in here?
Whoever it is, they'll go.
Menti, Myers, are you there?
That's Fokpa.
Praise God you are not harmed. You're making the right choice. It isn't safe to be here any longer. How can you teach about Jesus Christ when people's lives are at risk? Your mothers will be very happy to see you.
He's not going home. We're going to teach.
During the war?
Away from the war, where it is safe.
It's not safe in Moroga, my brother.
It is not safe anywhere. Then we will leave the country.
He's not kidding.
Are you just gonna pack up and drag a suitcase to Sierra Leone?
Sally? Anyone have a better idea?
Lay low. Stay inside. You can study if you want, but stay off the streets.
Brother Boubacar.
Stay out of the reach of the rebels. Look, stock food and water. Let's just wait this thing out.
There's no more food. The water is out too. Same with our place. And power has been gone for weeks.
What if you run into the rebels just walking down the street? What if they shoot you because you're Christian? Or because you're tall or not? Or for whatever reason?
Or they shoot us through our apartment door. Or we're hiding like cowards.
It is not cowardice to survive. We are not going to Freetown. It is not an option.
Brother Boubacar, you could drive them there.
No.
What else can we do?
There are rebels everywhere, in the city and in the jungle. They're going to set up roadblocks and checkpoints at every intersection between here and the border. Just finding petrol will take a miracle from God. Let's just wait here until...
We aren't any safer here than we are in the open air. I saw a man get shot right in front of our apartment this morning. Could have been any of us. We'll use the main road out of the city. But imagine we can run into trouble here.
Stop. All of you. This is just too fast. We need to think. Lives are at stake here, including us. I assured President Cunningham that I was going to keep you safe. And he trusts that I do the right thing. Look, I don't care if you're not going to teach another soul ever again. We are not going to Freetown.
Hymns, scriptures, the Savior. These were not always a part of my life. One day, I meet two men in white shirts and ties on the street. They ask me if they can share a message. I said no. It wasn't for me. Not after some of the things I have done. When I turned to leave, Elder Menti said, "Will you pray for us? Will you pray for us?" I didn't know who these missionaries were. I've never been to any church before. I've never even said a prayer before. But those simple words stuck in my mind. That night, before I went to bed, I spoke out loud to God. For the first time in my life, I said a prayer. I didn't even know if I did it right. I just talked. And it felt like I could tell him anything. It felt like he was actually listening to me. It was so easy. And that was the first time I ever said a prayer. If you deny them a chance to share this message with others, then the rebels have already won.
We don't even know if we can get there, let alone if we should.
When we leave our apartment every morning, we don't always know where we are going. Revelation doesn't come when we are hiding in the shadows or sitting on the ground asking for it. It doesn't come that way. It comes when we are out working, without knowing where we are going, constantly taking steps forward.
So when do we go?
We should sleep at the mission office tonight. And then we'll leave first thing tomorrow morning. What about Guy and Yanfo?
I'll go to Painesville tomorrow morning and tell them to meet you at the mission office.
There's no time to wait. No one gets left behind.
Thank you, sister.
At your service.
Where did all these people come from?
They are people that feel threatened. We're going with them in the morning to the northern region, where it's safer. You could stay with us.
Thank you, but we cannot leave the mission.
They're killing the Kran, and the rest they're taking to camps.
There's not enough food here for these people. Not even for tonight. We'll go and get something to eat.
No! The rebels are out there. Please.
We'll be fine.
I'll go with you.
Your name. They will question you. They will know.
I will go.
Be careful.
I love you, Daddy. Why is your friend?
He went out to look for food.
And you didn't go with him?
It's not safe for me out there.
Why not?
Some men we are taught to hate.
By who?
Men who we are hated.
again.
See, Quinn? He's a thief.
And then it shall come to pass that the spirits of those who are righteous are received into a state of happiness, which is called paradise, a state of rest, a state of peace, where they shall rest from all their troubles and from all care and sorrow.
Alma chapter 40. Rest from all their troubles. It seems difficult to believe at a time like this.
It seems like at a time like this, you have to believe.
Sure, but death is final. It's a lot of trouble for you to live through before you get to that state of paradise.
It does not say anything about needing to die before you can feel paradise.
Do you want to go with them tomorrow?
Don't you?
Dangerous.
So he's staying here. I'd rather find somewhere where we can teach than be here entrapped.
You can stay. We are only killing Kranz.
No. We stay together.
What if they catch us? What if they identify me?
It won't come to that. If someone asks you where you are from, say you are from here, born and raised in Pennsville. Stand up and be counted.
Stand up, be counted, and lie.
If it means saving your life. In the moment when there is a gun to your head and the sun is beating down, you must choose to live or die. Are you really going to die just to prove a point? Think of all the people you teach after this is all done. The rebels are killing Kranz just because they can. They're not the law of Liberia. The law of God. I'm not telling you to betray your tribe. Just preserve it. There's nothing wrong with that.
think I liked you better when you didn't talk.
You. Are you Grant?
No, I'm not Grant. I'm Gil.
You're lying.
Why? Why am I lying?
Because you fear me. Get the Grant dog.
Okay.
Huh?
What are you looking at? Do you ever think about paradise?
This is not the end.
Do you ever wonder how it feels like to be there?
And you, little mother, are you Gran?
I Gran. There's no shame in it.
Guy, you should run. I see my paradise.
It is beyond the river, near the jungle. Coconut palms and the salty breeze. I've never seen a more beautiful place like this.
Where do you come from?
Nakra.
And you? Are you a Kran? Janfor? Are you a Kran?
No, I'm not.
You, are you a Kran? Elder.
Elder is my title. I am an ordained minister of Jesus Christ.
I know them.
You know them?
They are from my church. Let me take them. I'll put them to work digging.
This one is a Kran.
He'll be treated as such.
Menti.
Yeah?
We don't have any bread, though.
What do we have?
Nothing much.
But we'll make it work.
For now, I'll ration it for the five of us.
Seven. They'll come.
We're gonna share them.
I think we just have to make do of what we have.
Yes, that's better.
But the food and all that, because...
Oh, no. No.
So what do we do?
Maybe we're gonna walk.
God. Were you born to worry?
I'm looking for the elder. The one who is Kran.
He used to live near us in the city, but we have not seen him.
Where? Tell me where you lived. Looking for elders. What do you want from this crown? What about you? Are you a crown? Huh? Lucky us.
Adamantis, we gotta go, we gotta go.
Hey, Obaka, come on.
Guys, we have to go.
Yeah, let's go. Come on in here for prayers.
Menti, why aren't they here?
I'll say it. Dear God, before we depart, we ask for thy watchful care. The journey we now feel prompted to take require thy protective hand. We are unsure as to what lies ahead. But Lord, we pray for the vehicle, that it will function properly and be able to handle the uncertain terrain. We pray for thy children who have sacrificed so much on our behalf. Help their faith to carry them through these difficult times. Bless those who remain, that their bed may be lightened. We pray for Guy and Yangfo. We've done our best to find them, but have been unsuccessful. Comfort them, O Lord. Be with them. Finally, we pray for our driver, Brother Philip Abubakar, and for the safety of him and his family, as we strive to do that which is impossible.
Menti, Elders, Abubakar, I found them in Paintsville. Let's go.
Elders.
We have to go now.
Brother Momoru, you need to come with us. These rebels have nothing for you.
I'll stay. They need me.
You have a good heart. Be strong, my brother.
You need to worry.
I can't help it.
right here, right now. Where is he?
He's been taken to Freetown. He's not a threat, Arthur.
Get up. You are coming with me. Come on, let's go.
Bentley's going to get hungry.
I am fine.
He already is.
I am fine. This is not going to be long, right?
Yeah, just 2 days, bro.
2 days?
Oh.
Wait, we stop for coconuts.
Yeah, let's do it.
Menti, I thought you said you were fine.
I mean, who says no to coconuts?
Nobody does that, you know? I don't have a map, but at least I can use the stones to indicate the MPFL checkpoints. Now, if you look at it very carefully,
you'll see. Hey, guys. Got some more coconuts.
Okay, so as I was saying, guys, come around.
Guys, come see, come here.
Okay. We're right here. This is our current position. And we're going to meet these three NPFL checkpoints. Mm-hmm. We'll go down this bridge, there's a river. So as soon as we turn, we'll get to the river. So we'll have to cross it and then move to the main interstate.
Is that Freetown?
Yes, somewhere right here.
I don't know. Is this our plan? And is it that map?
Yeah, that's the map.
Look, let's take this as... It's not a scale, but at least it can explain something.
I know our Freetown is supposed to be here.
Freetown. Right here, yeah.
Okay.
What is the difference between this and that? I don't know any sign that would show, but I know Freetown's right there. This is free. Let's say that is Freetown.
And is it the difference between this location and that location?
Okay, maybe
Freetown. That's Freetown.
Are you guys okay? Any questions?
The rebels, are they looking for Crown?
The rebels are there to cause trouble. Most of them are there for the money. And then some are there for food. And obviously, a few of them have been paid to report the Crown.
Or shoot them.
That guy, we won't let that happen.
Okay, so we need to get going now. Have to get going. Half it. Right.
Have faith, brother.
Seven of us in here.
Thank you.
looking for a crown.
We have a message for you. Have you heard of the Restored Gospel? We are missionaries for the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. When Christ was on the earth, he established a church with the priesthood authority. But that authority was removed after the 12 apostles were killed. Many years later, Christ restored his gospel with the priesthood power through a prophet by name Joseph Smith.
If you receive this gospel and repent, you'll be happy. I'd love to share more with you and your friends.
Wow.
What?
We're nice.
Supposed to open our mouth. Don't we?
Yes, of course.
That was great, man.
Supposed to drop by now.
Did you say that mission, Philip?
No. I joined the church after I got married.
How did you find the church?
You know, before I joined the church, I would hear about the Mormons and their evil and strange ways. It was never a good thing. Then one day I see this young man walking by the streets, teaching people about God. Then I started to pay close attention. But it was never like people would say. Now even when people would not listen to them, they could. They would even show kindness and sometimes even help. Then I thought to myself, what type of evil would compel people to do such good? I just couldn't figure it out. It didn't make sense to me.
Cognitive dissonance.
Yeah.
Confusion. When you learn the truth that conflicts with what you already believe, your mind isn't comfortable with it. You know, the church used to have a policy that excluded Africans from the priesthood. We were banned. Not allowed. Denied. I remember learning about it after joining the church. Here I was, one of the first Liberians to be baptized into the church. One of the first priesthood holders in the country. The priesthood has changed my life more than I could ever hope for. Talk about confusion. Doesn't God love all his children? Why would his organization, which is truly led by a prophet, have such a racist policy? I couldn't get my head around it. Cognitive dissonance.
But you did.
God allows us to change. He wants us to change. The power of the atonement is that Christ died for everyone. Being able to change, to improve, to move forward, it is for everyone. When one person changes for good, God forgives and rejoices.
You know, it feels like the same way when I joined.
How long ago was that?
That was about 5 years ago.
5 years.
Now look at where we are. Worst mistake ever.
were some missionaries driving on this route. Did you see them?
There were some missionaries all in white.
How long ago did they pass through?
Maybe an hour ago.
Leave the kit, leave the kit.
Seizure.
We could keep her in the mission office or even in the church.
Philip, they are here to teach and we cannot ask them to waste their time.
They should go back to their families, move on with their lives, instead of being a horrible burden on everyone.
Burden? Is it a burden to serve? Is it a burden to help someone in need? You don't pray to have more faith and just expect it to come.
Get through?
Not unless we move it out ourselves.
I'll go have a look. Passed out. Myers, come help me.
Don't make any noise.
Here.
What are you doing with this?
Save their lives.
We'll go out and help them.
No. This is faster. We need to be ready to go if they wake up.
They're not waking up.
No, go put it back, go put it back.
there.
Mason, freeze. Wait,
stop.
He's going to...
Hey, stop.
He's going to shoot. Mason.
Hey, stop. Stop the car. Where are the keys?
Can you be any more louder?
I'm sorry, I didn't know it would fall apart like that.
But wait, how do you know you wouldn't shoot?
Because you can't shoot what you don't have.
What are you doing with that?
It's okay, brother. Brother Philip, we'll give it to someone in need.
Mubaka, we should pull over. You need to get some rest.
So we're going to sleep here and everyone takes what for an hour?
90 minutes.
Why does it matter?
Because a full REM cycle is 90 minutes and it's more healthful.
Okay, whatever.
So why are we sleeping?
Why are we sleeping?
Just find a spot.
Who takes what first? So why are we sleeping?
I'll go. I'll watch first.
You watch first. Okay, good. We just make camp here. Everybody okay? Yeah.
Yeah.
You're disturbing.
My time to watch.
You're gonna need this.
Yanfo said you were face to face with a crown killer.
Omolu saved us. His timing was lucky.
He interfered?
Yes.
Maybe there is hope for him. All in God's time.
I was standing there at the end of this row of people. I watched as the guard interrogated each person. I kept wondering, is it fair for anyone to die like this? It was just as Nyanfo had suggested the night before, being faced with the choice to live or to die. I was ready to lie when the question came. I wanted to be brave and tell the truth. But there was an old woman before us. She was brave. But he shot her without blinking. I didn't want to be brave after that. It didn't seem worth it. I was afraid.
You shouldn't feel bad about that.
Scripture says, fear not, Isaiah, Samuel, Moroni.
Look at where you are and what you're doing. You could have stayed in the city and hid, but you're here, moving forward, trying to live.
Is it brave just to try to live?
It is brave to face your fears.
Yeah.
Soldier, lift again. Lift again.
See something?
Just an abandoned car.
Why are you protecting him?
Protecting who, Anza?
Liberia will suffer for those actions. It must be stopped. Do favors his people over others. He stole the power of the government, and he is there illegally. Holds it over us, giving positions of leadership to his people. The crowds think they are all better than us. This boy you are protecting is one of them. They are responsible for this war. They are responsible for the death of my father, my mother, and my two younger brothers. I will not stop hunting and killing crowns until they are all gone. Liberia will not be well with them. Never.
Hatred breeds hatred. We'll catch them at the border.
You want some breakfast?
Everybody happy now?
Did you sleep well?
Ooh, that stinks.
Let's go over there. Want some breakfast?
Not if it's yams.
I think I slept a little wrong. Elanga salamanga, elanga,
hey. One more day until we are free.
One more day until we can teach.
One more day until this car can rest.
Watch is over all of us.
Yeah.
Finally, TJ.
I'll be fine. I don't care. I'm just going.
Mata, he's always there for us. Come on, Selly, get back in.
He loves you.
We'll always love you.
Elanga salamanga, elanga buke.
What's going on?
The puddle. I bet it's all mud underneath.
Can you go around?
Everything is mushy and wet.
My eyes, let's take a look.
Okay.
Huh.
See if you can make it through. Doesn't look bad that side.
Think so?
Yeah.
Abubakar, come drive through it.
I've done it once.
Wow.
Looks good. I think we can make it.
Guys, if the water has been settling for a while, the ground will be very, very soft.
Miles, nobody cares. Let's just do it. Then go ahead. I will walk.
Well?
Yeah, we'll go then. Let's give it enough gas and we'll go right through. Have faith, brother.
God, I pray the risers and better be risers too.
To walk on water, or we sure can drive through it.
Rebels again?
This one's not serious.
Rebel or national?
Does it matter?
No, don't say.
Why so many in the car?
We don't have a church van.
You have to pay for each passenger.
We have very little money on us.
Huh? Pay! Or turn around and go back.
We don't even have money.
But bring out the little we have.
Yeah. I don't really want to survive to get that.
And his own brush.
Toothbrush? What are we going to use toothbrush for?
Why your
pen? Need some.
I need his pen. For what? Don't let us go. This is all we have.
This is enough for five. Wait. Yeah.
Okay. Oh,
please, yeah.
That's true.
Please.
Okay,
six.
We don't have any more money. That's it. That's all we have.
My friend, I said six.
Wait, I have something.
What?
Look at this. 3, 2, 1.
Dead. Good. That's the last drop.
All right. And you are chosen ones. This is the end of the line.
We are not there yet.
I know we are not there yet, but just how far your fates will get us.
So much for who will be okay, brother.
Yeah, we'll be okay.
We'll be okay, brother.
Yeah, we'll be okay. We'll be okay walking to Freetown. Even a traveling band of miracle workers cannot predict everything.
Oh, brother, Boubacar, take it easy. What is your faith?
Can you see I'm easy? I'm so easy. I've got faith, loads of it. I was just saying...
Guys, there's a petrol station right here.
You hear that?
Come on, let's go.
Come on.
Brother Boubacar.
Boubacar.
Faith. Faith. Let's go.
Okay, it's okay.
We asked you for $85 a gallon in Pennsville. That's $85 more than we have.
Just say a prayer and hope they are kind to us.
You've been traveling for long.
Yes, sir, we've been traveling for long.
And it's not been easy?
Not at all. It's not been easy. We will need your help. We want to buy petrol, but we don't have any money. We can give anything, everything that we have.
You've been traveling with your sons?
They are not my sons.
Not your sons?
I guess in a way you can say they are.
And you have all of them in that tiny car?
Yes. All the way from Monrovia.
Monrovia? And where are you going?
Freetown. How far are we from the border?
Oh, not far. But you must be careful. The road is very bad. And even though you are close, you still have to drive slowly.
We'll do that.
And soon you will catch up with your friend. Earlier on, a man came here looking for a bunch of men wearing white and claiming he was very anxious to catch up with you. Don't worry. I'll help you.
Open the trunk. Give it to him.
What?
All of it.
That should be enough to take you there.
Not far from the border. What if you don't find them, sir?
We will find them.
But what if you don't?
We must find them. Because if we don't, I'll deal with it. I'll make sure that you and any other person you care about. Wish that we had.
Help me.
Is it okay now?
Yeah, it's okay. We're good to go, guys.
Philip,
let's go faster.
Look, I can't go any faster. We have to be careful of the ties.
There are rocks on the
place. I wish you guys could be up front here to see it.
So if I should get down and walk, I'll even get there faster.
Keep going, now we're really making good time.
Philip! Yes?
The rocks are very small.
Oh, look, we just got two more bumps.
No, everyone's there. The one jockey going down, the one driving.
It is still bumpy.
The rebels.
Oh, my God.
Guys, come, come.
There's no proof on my shoes.
You see that one?
I can't believe I overcast. I think I should do this.
Hey, need some help?
No. You have a good driver.
He's a good man. Philip, everywhere is clear. Philip, don't try me. I'm warning you.
Let's go, let's go, let's go.
This is your last chance.
You should get up so that you can jog.
How was the exercise?
Thank you.
Next time, I'll drive your job. I think Menti's hungry.
I'm ready for this trip to be over, guys.
Endure to the end, brother.
I don't think my hand can endure much more.
I wouldn't be opposed to a shower.
I wouldn't be opposed to you having a shower.
When do you think things will be back to normal?
Normal?
Yes.
Define normal.
I don't know.
We can go outside and not talk about all these things that we have seen. The rebels, the killings, and the hatred.
Never. There will always be more of it if we keep allowing it.
That's bleak, man.
He's right.
Maybe. Just seems bleak.
It is, if you see it that way. But the fact is, there are going to be permanent consequences to all our actions. The families that were displaced, the lives that were lost, those things can never be back to normal. And there will always be more of it. More fighting, more wars, more racism. Nothing that can be done can make that better. But you cannot argue over spilled water. You cannot dwell in the injustice of the past, but rather anticipate hope of the future.
Look, if we hurry, we can make it before dark. But just get your passports ready.
Anyone needs their bags? Anyone? Menti? Sally, anyone?
Get your papers ready.
Anyone needs their bag?
Papa.
Brother Rubakar.
Careful.
Yes? Thinking that you don't have a passport to get across the border? Why think you could just show up and share a scripture, sing a hymn, and they'll let you cross? That is not the way things work. We didn't know.
Some of us have never left the country before.
Clearly. And we ain't going to tell them that. We're sorry, forgive us. They were not abiding by your laws. We've never left the country. I've been traveling for 2 days with barely enough sleep and barely enough food. listening to your miracle stories and faith-promoting coincidences. And yet not one of you would just sit down to think that if you just take a little time to prepare, then God will not have to work so hard to watch out for you. Look, I'm sorry, okay? It's just that we've worked so hard, and a lot has happened to get us this far. And it's been like miracle after miracle.
Then why are you doubting?
Is faith supposed to be this exhausting?
Let's finish this. Elanga salamanga, elanga pehe. Elanga.
Telling me how this fits into the plan.
There's nothing we could have done differently. All the preparation in the world wouldn't have opened this bridge for us.
So what do we do? We find a place to sleep and head back in the morning.
Yeah. But would the Lord bring us this far only to turn us away?
Did we do all we can?
Philip? Where are you going?
Just going for a walk. Look, stay by the car, would you?
What are we doing here if we're going to be turned away? What good is it? You control everything. Through our son, you've shown power to even feed thousands.
You've calmed the seas.
and even walk on water. Let's go.
What? What happened?
Good morning.
Is it?
What did I miss?
A glorious sunrise. Good morning, Abubakar.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Let's go. Up. Hey, come on, guys. We're going to Freetown today.
What? How do you know that?
Because you, my brother. Seven and all powerful gun.
The Lord provides the way.
Yes, he does.
At this rate, you are going to be here for a while.
Yes.
You got anything to do to pass away your time?
Yes, we can go here. Okay, guys.
Brothers, hey, hey!
Do whatever he says, please.
Pull the car away and get out, all of you. Let's go. Right there, let's go.
Back up, bottom! Back up! I'll give every last one of you for having this crime, starting with him. Move! Move back!
These young men are missionaries.
You've done nothing wrong.
Hey! What are you doing? Hold it right there. Hey, you! What are you doing? Huh? What is your authority? Who is that? Who are you?
My name is Elder John Gae.
Let him go.
He is one of those people. He is a crown.
I said let him go. Where are you from?
I'm from Monrovia, sir. I left my home and my family to serve the people of Liberia for 2 years. I'm a volunteer.
And you are all with him? And you want to leave Liberia?
Sir, we have been unable to teach for over 6 months now because of rebel fighting. We are going to Freetown to continue teaching until conditions in Monrovia are safe to return.
And you all made it here in this thing?
Yeah. On one tank of petrol, with no flats, and very little damage to the undercarriage.
And you? Why you want to deny them passage?
There is no place for any crown in this country.
And you? Whose side you on?
Little crown lover, I have sworn to protect our great nation Liberia by eliminating all filthy crowns, and he is a crown.
And so am I. Get them on the next ferry, wherever they need to go. Now.
Across.
He had faith. Faith we would.
How did you know?
I didn't know. I didn't ever know. Somewhere along the way, between the mission office and the rebel checkpoints, between running out of petrol but somehow always having enough, or children fleeing from rebels but smiling whenever they see you, between hoping for the future but fearing what was ahead,
It just doesn't make sense to doubt anymore.
Thank you, Abubakar.
Sally, when we get there, don't let Sister Cunningham see you. You're kind of a mess.
I stand next to Myers, I'll look just fine.
Hey, what do you mean? I'll look fine.
This is it. Let's go say hello.
Elder Menti. Elder Myers?
Let's go say hello.
All right.
How are you?
Oh, my.
You made it.
Yes.
So glad you're here.
Look at you.
It's so good to see you.
Elder.
Please, come in. Come in. There's plenty of room.
Is that work?
Lots of work.
Good.
Hello, President.
What are you doing?
I thought I should remove the battery to keep it safe.
Everything is safe. Brother Abubakar, you've done everything I asked. Thank you.
It's a pleasure.
Salam Mangal.